Hello Galactic Family. Welcome aboard. Gaia Planetary Station is happy that you like the messages and information we communicate. Help the channel to grow by subscribing, commenting on the video, sharing, becoming a member and donating to the channel. We always appreciate good energies and vibrations. We are together in this new era, ground crew, stay strong. Victory of Light. Hello Galactic Family, the meaning of life. Perceive every event in your nearest environment and in the world by deriving lessons for yourself. This is the way of wisdom. I am Jesus Christ. Everything happens so that you can grow. Your spiritual growth is the only reason of your existence on this earth. Slowly you unfold and life by life you go up the steps of knowledge. Now it is a matter of you gaining the meaning from this unreal world. The meaning is to take your place, to swim against the current and in the end, against all trends, opinions and beliefs of the collective, to arrive at the source. The vast majority of people tend to choose seemingly easy and simple paths. Although all screws are now being turned to raise people's vibration, many people do not want to leave their familiar cave and they remain stuck in their tar boots. Young souls do not condemn these inexperienced souls, for they do not know what they are doing, and if they did, they would not be willing to change it. What wants to be experienced, should be experienced. A young soul has thereby completely different requirements than an older soul. A young soul has chosen quite different adventures than an older soul. While you long for the light, someone else wants to experience the darkness. While you choose freedom, peace and love, some fellow soul is drawn in the opposite direction. Understanding the incomprehensible behavior of many is of great importance today. Why is something the way it is? Why are people the way they are? Because everything obeys its own rhythm and each person follows his soul plan. For the older souls, today is the time to fully align the inner compass with the light and with the high vibration that is now reaching the earth. It is time to love yourself. If your neighbor continues to live his old life, if your old friends keep their habits, yes, if even your family does not want to know about the ascension and change, then stay with yourself and firmly oriented in yourself. God is your guide, your guiding thought and your light in the darkness. God is always with you, a support and refuge, and it is God who sends you people whose souls are just as ready for change as you are. Old friends are leaving, new ones are coming. It is the time of transformation and every event offers you the opportunity for it. There are favorable conditions for your unfoldment. While the pressure on the outside is increasing, you can grow on the inside. You are meant you who have not chosen an easy or simple life, but a challenging life. This adventure requires all your effort. Your talents must be wisely managed and increased. Your inner light wants to shine and your love wants to reach the hearts of people. And growing struggles. You play the game of life on another level, a dimension that still eludes many people. You act out of understanding, you respond with compassion, and love is the leaven that rises today. You want to complete your circle of life and lose yourself completely in God. You swim against the current and you speak another language. Man does not understand you, but you are recognized by God. JJK, I live my life in growing rings that stretch over things. I may not accomplish the last one, but I will try. I circle around God, around the ancient tower, and I circle for millennia. And I do not yet know, am I a hawk, a storm, or a great song? These wonderful verses come to mind now. Jesus Christ, Try with all your heart and the attempt will succeed. Be completely with it and be ready to give up everything. Friends, opinions and beliefs will now be subjected to a thorough examination. You will be confronted with new ideas, sensations and realizations every day and will be equipped with new impulses. Implement what you realize and never look back. It is the time of the big changes. The whole earth is reshaping itself. But the greatest revolution is happening in you, it is the completion of your soul. The elder soul knows, beloved human being, go your way undauntedly until you arrive. For this you have seen the light of this world and therefore you know the value of each day. An older soul grows with each day and knows how to interpret the reflections. An older soul derives lessons for itself from every event and spiritual growth happens. An older soul knows the way of wisdom. Blessed is the one who looks at people full of love before he passes through the gate of light and becomes one in glory with God. I am Jesus Christ. This message is more necessary now than ever before. I take time to detail the situation, and so this piece is long and involved. To benefit from it, one must have attention span endurance. I trust it will be worth it, for those who do. Frequently over the past month, I've received a powerful message I find confirmed by many other sources. As of the last couple of months, humanity is in an alchemical pressure cooker, set at a spiritual heat of a degree we have not experienced before, and it's forcing a process within us that will launch us into a new time, if we cooperate with it fully. Increasing solar flares, photon rays, source energy, and our own internal pressure to purge, heal, and be free are cooking us, refining us into worthy spiritual vessels for a new age. To cooperate with this divinely orchestrated process, we have to choose to make a very specific shift in consciousness and behavior now that will alter life on Earth for the better. We have to surrender our old selves based on resistance to anything, and start to act like the highly evolved beings will be when we get to the next level. I am writing this with the holiday holy day season in mind, so hold on to that thought as you read ahead. Heavenly powers are bathing the planet in light and love, oneness energy, pushing on a hypnotized and largely uncooperative humanity, and eliciting great resistance from the entrenched evil that wants humanity to stay asleep and imprisoned, those that use fear and lies to divide and conquer. It is understood now that our transition into a new time has been impeded by seemingly external forces far more powerful than we previously realized, that cannot relinquish control and are bent on sabotaging our natural progression, more accurately referred to as remembering what we really are. They have done everything they can to keep us from the truth. We have allowed ourselves to submit to their lie and forget or ignore what we really are. The reason we have been having so much trouble with this changeover is that we think we are people. Our solution is to remember we are spirits of divine consciousness, happy, free sparks of loving light, so that we stop acting like clueless, reactionary, powerless victims. The cosmic pressure cooker is containing us. And there is no escape from this fact. As we are part of a living dream called life emanating from the divine mind, the challenge we are facing is primarily an internal one, not to be misunderstood as a literal battle between good and evil in which we are warriors. It looks that way to the ego in fear and separation, forgetting its innate oneness with the source. But this process is a healing, meaning, a unification, of the global psyche of humanity, who, in its delusion of feeling separated from its source, had learned to believe it is the victim of external forces. The fact is, there are no external forces because the universe is one thing. Everything going on in the universe is inside it, part of it. The common sense idea that the universe is expanding into empty space is wrong. The universe is all there is. There is no space beyond it to expand into. If there were extra space, it would be, by definition, part of the universe. Edwin Hubble, astronomer. Life is the divine experiencing itself as the universe, including us. We are its tools of awareness and action. We are the flowers of consciousness growing in the universal garden. And we have the power to create. Right now, though, the universe is experiencing us thrashing around trying to get free of our own illusions, believing them to be real things at odds with us. When spellbound by the ego mind, the drama looks very real, like a battle. It's meant to. It is the reflection we need to show us what is going on inside, what we are creating. The external drama is here to force us to stop being divisive and reactive, to unify, and to become, instead, creative. Instead of believing that the reflection is real and wasting enormous amounts of time and energy trying to fight off what we don't want in order to have what we do want, we must realize that only by putting our energy into creating what we do want can we have it. Fighting neutralizes our ability to create, exactly the way our biological system funnels its energy away from producing new growth and into defense when under pressure. If the alternative media representatives such as Simon Parks would spend half as much time reminding us of our divine heritage as powerful creators as they do in giving endless blow-by-blow descriptions of every scene in the drama, we would have reached critical mass years ago. But it is not their fault entirely. They are filling a need the human ego has to get immersed in drama, an addiction we need to drop immediately. Change your channel to a higher frequency, and see healthier results. Our situation is often referred to as a war, but that is just the ego's skewed viewpoint. Life is not war. It is play. What we are experiencing is an inexorable movement forward into a more positive experience made possible by the Source. It is a creative project in which a new world is substituted for an old one. All fighting is completely unnecessary, and all referencing to life now as a battle is counterproductive, an obsolete, Piscean age, old paradigm, dominator mentality, self-defeating mechanism. Either we accept the mantle of responsible creators and imagine into being our new world, or we stay frozen in time and at the effect of. Life is composting the old forms while producing new, improved ones. But our group ego wants to believe that change is happening because it is successfully fighting off enemies and will eventually control the situation. The alliance is in total control. Parrots one common mem. This is a delusion. Life is in control, and the reason change is happening now when it never could before is because, 1/life itself is making it happen. And 2/enough of us are now saying yes to it and have been willing to work on our inner material. Think about this. It is the only answer to why we have been unable for so long to effect positive change in our world. Humanity is not yet in an age of peace, happiness, and freedom because it has not yet chosen and fully committed to have unity and to return to its original state of innocence. It has not surrendered its obsession with duality, judgment, blame, and conflict. Dark and light are complementary forces alternating in dominance, like day and night do, but in fact are just two sides of the same one thing playing a game of catch with itself. Humanity is now at the point where it must accept that the strategy of fighting against enemies is self-defeating. Only by dropping this egocentric viewpoint and falling into the natural mind of unity consciousness can we embrace the dark and light inside us, and in holding them together as one, transcend war to have peace. This is so simple it sounds stupid. To have peace, we must stop fighting. To have a higher level world, we have to behave that way, because we are the world. Learning this great lesson allows humanity to live in a state where there is respected individuality and community, independence in cooperation, and prosperity and sharing. This is the state of the Aquarian Age, one of unity consciousness, not fear-driven, desperate, savior-seeking behavior, that accomplishes this transition. We simply cannot fight our way into the next highest dimension. The key to doing this and resolving our global dilemma is to disengage from identifying with the ego in separation with all its fearful, negative imagery, and useless, self-centered, reactive behaviors, and to fall back into trust of our natural state, unity consciousness. This, in fact, is the ultimate premise and teaching of all true systems of spiritual cultivation, from the ancient mystery schools of Egypt and Greece, which spun the original and true cult of Christianity, Gnosticism, to Polynesian and Oriental mysticism, which birthed Huna and Taoism, spiritual cultures based on loving relationship with all beings, the earth, and the heavens. These oneness-based religions reflect our origins and our destiny. Their purpose is to make us remember that each one of us is a Christ. From an inner state of unity, which implies a deep and total trust of the divine, everything is handled perfectly, effortlessly, without interference, because there is alignment with the divine source, which really is omniscient, omnipresent, and omnipotent. In other words, the ego is no longer directing the action, the inner Christ is. This is the natural way, our natural way. Enough of us right now are going to have to get effing tired enough of the suffering egocentrism has produced that we willingly surrender our gripes and addictions for a higher experience. This is a soul maturing process. We are going through the personal ordeal of self-examination and self-purification, turning our lead into gold. Our old, rigid forms of isolated egos are being cooked down into a cosmic soup made of relaxed and unified ingredients, all of which are still recognizable for what they individually are. Our purified essences alone can enter the next level of human experience. So, again, how this is not a battle. Understand that the dark force is a manifestation of unresolved energies in our group psyche control us as long as we fight with them, with each other, or within our own individual psyches, because they are our forces gone wayward, left unattended. Change your perspective from other-based to unity-based and this becomes clear. When we stop using fighting as a way to cope with life, an act that takes place in the dark of our soul, and turn to higher, brighter, love-based consciousness, we shift our frequency, and that higher rate of vibration, divine light consciousness, disappears the darkness. Our darkness. As we are not yet conscious that all is one, we have to learn now to bring consciousness to our situation in order to change it. The psychological rule says that when an inner situation is not made conscious, it happens outside, as fate. That is to say, when the individual remains divided and does not become conscious of his inner opposite, the world must perforce act out the conflict and be torn into opposing halves. The individual soul psyche is a microcosm of the group soul of humanity, the macrocosm. This is how it will be done. As many are now realizing when they ask why this is taking so long, the strength of the dark forces had been greatly underestimated. It's taken so long because we haven't spent enough time going through the inner ordeal of self-examination, owning up to what's been inside us, and applying love and forgiveness so we can heal unify. Note, forgiving does not mean condoning. It means letting something go so we can move on. This process entails correction, but not punishment. We have been too entertained by looking outside ourselves as a diversion to keep from realizing just how much pain and suffering has been inside. That's why we are finding so much hidden dark behavior in our society now. The outer world comes from the inner world and is its reflection. We have been trying to take the easy way out through blame and distraction. Fortunately, We are now being forced to come clean by the incoming light and love of the universe. It is this divine energy that is making it possible for any earthly forces like white hats to make progress in cleaning up the cabal. This loving light, not any external entity like the Alliance, is the real Calvary, the true Messiah. Author's rebuke: sorry Christian friends, Jesus is not going to save you. That idea is the biggest piece of propaganda ever presented to humanity by its dark forces. One has to go through the personal ordeal of self-examination for oneself. Jesus' primary mission was to show us what it's like to be free so we could opt for that. When he said, "All the things I can do, you can do," he wasn't kidding, because his primary message was, "Be like me." To get all excited and jump up and down doing a devotion dance where you proclaim how wonderful it was that Jesus died for your sins and now you don't have to do a damn thing but accept Jesus as your personal savior and you'll be fine is a total, irresponsible delusion, and it is holding back the evolution of humanity because of that. So get up off your lazy, self-righteous butts and practice what he preached. Truth and reconciliation for those nasty SATA.NI.ST buggers and acceptance of all others whose forms don't meet your self-important standards. Those of us who do love-based spiritual practices that you insist on misrepresenting as devil worship instead of trying to show how forgiven and better you all are. It's Christmas, which is really solstice, so now's a good time to drop this load and help the cause. Amen. The key factor. Understanding all this reveals the key factor that clarifies why we haven't reached our breakthrough point yet. That factor has been disunity. The lack of dynamic, cooperative group focus on a stated intent is powerful divine beings from a unified level of consciousness among those of us who want a new earth. I previously have believed that our delays were being caused mostly by the normies, the laggard population that refuses to look at anything, especially the truth. Recently, I have come to understand that it is more our responsibility because, while they have tremendous inertia, we are the ones with the power to change things because we who are more conscious of what's really going on are the ones who can willingly use our divinely bestowed creative ability. If we just get organized and do it. Intention put forth with the proper feeling tone creates reality. Though we may be a small percentage of the world population, our combined, resonant energies can shift the frequency here, because when we unify stopping all negative, divisive or self-indulgent behavior, the radiant field we create will be more powerful than the one that has existed up to now. And just as a large tuning fork will change the frequency note emanating from a smaller one next to it, our unified, superior tone, in alignment with divine powers, will wash over the planet, and change its entire field. We actually have been doing this in increments, slowly over time, and we are close to a shift of great proportion. As we watch the old false narratives crumbling rapidly now, we need to boost our efforts to transcend our ego's differing agendas and focus on what we have in common. We want a free world aligned with spirit. We want to live happily ever after. I have written articles in the past about the importance of the solstices and equinoxes as huge natural doorways where spirit comes through to recreate life on Earth. Solstices and equinoxes are three-day windows of pure primordial energy, the most spiritually powerful days of the year. Creation, which is the body of spirit, is innately aligned with itself from top to bottom, and the love and light released from the purest levels of spirit make their way down through the dimensions to us in especially powerful ways at these temporal markers. These times are more than just astrological transits. They are cosmic doorways to the infinite. Winter solstice is the segue between the ending of one solar year and the beginning of a new one. The last molecules of one year's energy breath are spent, and there is a pause of deepest profundity before the universe sends out a new breath of life, a new solar year. It is the emptiest of times, and emptiness is what we need now to make our shift. Willfully surrendering our old world and old personal selves with their painful memories into the spiritual void of the solstice allows us to recreate ourselves and our world by then inputting our vision and excitement for a better world. The surrender of our past is our yes to our new future. During this 3-day transition period, the day before, the day of, and the day after, in between 1 year and the next, the universe vacuums out old energies and polishes everything in creation. It cleans house for us. Because of all the momentum we've built thus far, banding together under our shared intention at this particular time, especially at the exact hour of the solstice, will be extraordinarily powerful. Our intention is to have a unified, free world. This is what we are creating to replace the suffering-filled one we created when we got confused a long, long time ago and forgot what we really are. Stop obsessing on what all the little players on the stage are doing and go within. Don't listen when anyone tells you to stock up, there might be shortages. Instead, picture how you prefer it to be and put your faith in that image. See a fullness of life experience instead of the passé images of lack we were taught to believe in. Gather yourself in the quiet space and meditate and imagine, pray with confident intent as a great being aligned with the infinite source who owns his or her innate power. Do this as much as possible starting now, especially at the solstice, and continuing daily thereafter, and see the magic of life spring us forth into a new world of unity, peace, prosperity, freedom, and love. Imagine it real now. Forgive and forget everything else, the meaning of life. Perceive every event in your nearest environment and in the world by deriving lessons for yourself. This is the way of wisdom. I am Jesus Christ. Everything happens so that you can grow. Your spiritual growth is the only reason of your existence on this earth. Slowly you unfold and life by life you go up the steps of knowledge. Now it is a matter of you gaining the meaning from this unreal world. The meaning is to take your place, to swim against the current and in the end, against all trends, opinions and beliefs of the collective, to arrive at the source. The vast majority of people tend to choose seemingly easy and simple paths. Although all screws are now being turned to raise people's vibration, many people do not want to leave their familiar cave and they remain stuck in their tar boots. Young souls do not condemn these inexperienced souls, for they do not know what they are doing, and if they did, they would not be willing to change it. What wants to be experienced should be experienced. A young soul has thereby completely different requirements than an older soul. A young soul has chosen quite different adventures than an older soul. While you long for the light, someone else wants to experience the darkness. While you choose freedom, peace and love, some fellow soul is drawn in the opposite direction. Understanding the incomprehensible behavior of many is of great importance today. Why is something the way it is? Why are people the way they are? Because everything obeys its own rhythm and each person follows his soul plan. For the older souls, today is the time to fully align the inner compass with the light and with the high vibration that is now reaching the earth. It is time to love yourself. If your neighbor continues to live his old life, if your old friends keep their habits, yes, if even your family does not want to know about the ascension and change, then stay with yourself and firmly oriented in yourself. God is your guide, your guiding thought and your light in the darkness. God is always with you, a support and refuge, and it is God who sends you people whose souls are just as ready for change as you are. Old friends are leaving, new ones are coming. It is the time of transformation, and every event offers you the opportunity for it. There are favorable conditions for your unfoldment. While the pressure on the outside is increasing, you can grow on the inside. You are meant you who have not chosen an easy or simple life, but a challenging life. This adventure requires all your effort. Your talents must be wisely managed and increased. Your inner light wants to shine, and your love wants to reach the hearts of people. And growing struggles. You play the game of life on another level, a dimension that still eludes many people. You act out of understanding, you respond with compassion, and love is the leaven that rises today. You want to complete your circle of life and lose yourself completely in God. You swim against the current and you speak another language. Man does not understand you, but you are recognized by God. JJK, I live my life in growing rings that stretch over things. I may not accomplish the last one, but I will try. I circle around God, around the ancient tower, and I circle for millennia. And I do not yet know, am I a hawk, a storm, or a great song? These wonderful verses come to mind now. Jesus Christ, try with all your heart and the attempt will succeed. Be completely with it and be ready to give up everything. Friends, opinions and beliefs will now be subjected to a thorough examination. You will be confronted with new ideas, sensations and realizations every day and will be equipped with new impulses. Implement what you realize and never look back. It is the time of the big changes. The whole earth is reshaping itself. But the greatest revolution is happening in you. It is the completion of your soul. The elder soul knows, beloved human being, go your way undauntedly until you arrive. For this you have seen the light of this world, and therefore you know the value of each day. An older soul grows with each day and knows how to interpret the reflections. An older soul derives lessons for itself from every event, and spiritual growth happens. An older soul knows the way of wisdom. Blessed is the one who looks at people full of love before he passes through the gate of light and becomes one in glory with God. I am Jesus Christ. This message is more necessary now than ever before. I take time to detail the situation. And so this piece is long and involved. To benefit from it, one must have attention span endurance. I trust it will be worth it, for those who do. P. Frequently over the past month, I've received a powerful message I find confirmed by many other sources. As of the last couple of months, humanity is in an alchemical pressure cooker, set at a spiritual heat of a degree we have not experienced before, and it's forcing a process within us that will launch us into a new time, if we cooperate with it fully. Increasing solar flares, photon rays, source energy, and our own internal pressure to purge, heal, and be free are cooking us, refining us into worthy spiritual vessels for a new age. To cooperate with this divinely orchestrated process, we have to choose to make a very specific shift in consciousness and behavior now that will alter life on Earth for the better. We have to surrender our old selves based on resistance to anything, and start to act like the highly evolved beings will be when we get to the next level. I am writing this with the holiday Holy Day season in mind, so hold on to that thought as you read ahead. Heavenly powers are bathing the planet in light and love, oneness energy, pushing on a hypnotized and largely uncooperative humanity, and eliciting great resistance from the entrenched evil that wants humanity to stay asleep and imprisoned, those that use fear and lies to divide and conquer. It is understood now that our transition into a new time has been impeded by seemingly external forces far more powerful than we previously realized, that cannot relinquish control and are bent on sabotaging our natural progression, more accurately referred to as remembering what we really are. They have done everything they can to keep us from the truth. We have allowed ourselves to submit to their lie and forget or ignore what we really are. The reason we have been having so much trouble with this changeover is that we think we are people. Our solution is to remember we are spirits of divine consciousness, happy, free sparks of loving light, so that we stop acting like clueless, reactionary, powerless victims. The cosmic pressure cooker is containing us, and there is no escape from this fact. As we are part of a living dream called life emanating from the divine mind, the challenge we are facing is primarily an internal one, not to be misunderstood as a literal battle between good and evil in which we are warriors. It looks that way to the ego in fear and separation, forgetting its innate oneness with the source. But this process is a healing, meaning, a unification, of the global psyche of humanity, who, in its delusion of feeling separated from its source, had learned to believe it is the victim of external forces. The fact is, there are no external forces because the universe is one thing. Everything going on in the universe is inside it, part of it. A common sense idea that the universe is expanding into empty space is wrong. The universe is all there is. There is no space beyond it to expand into. If there were extra space, it would be, by definition, part of the universe. Dwin Hubble, astronomer. Life is the divine experiencing itself as the universe, including us. We are its tools of awareness and action. We are the flowers of consciousness growing in the universal garden. And we have the power to create. Right now though, the universe is experiencing us thrashing around trying to get free of our own illusions, believing them to be real things at odds with us. When spellbound by the ego mind, the drama looks very real, like a battle. It's meant to. It is the reflection we need to show us what is going on inside, what we are creating. The external drama is here to force us to stop being divisive and reactive, to unify, and to become, instead, creative. Instead of believing that the reflection is real and wasting enormous amounts of time and energy trying to fight off what we don't want in order to have what we do want, we must realize that only by putting our energy into creating what we do want can we have it. Fighting neutralizes our ability to create, exactly the way our biological system funnels its energy away from producing new growth and into defense when under pressure. If the alternative media representatives such as Simon Parks would spend half as much time reminding us of our divine heritage as powerful creators as they do in giving endless blow-by-blow descriptions of every scene in the drama, we would have reached critical mass years ago. But it is not their fault entirely. They are filling a need the human ego has to get immersed in drama, an addiction we need to drop immediately. Change your channel to a higher frequency, and see healthier results. Our situation is often referred to as a war, but that is just the ego's skewed viewpoint. Life is not war. It is play. What we are experiencing is an inexorable movement forward into a more positive experience made possible by the source. It is a creative project in which a new world is substituted for an old one. All fighting is completely unnecessary, and all referencing to life now as a battle is counterproductive, an obsolete, Piscean age, old paradigm, dominator mentality, self-defeating mechanism. Either we accept the mantle of responsible creators and imagine into being our new world, or we stay frozen in time and at the effect of. Life is composting the old forms while producing new, improved ones, but our group ego wants to believe that change is happening because it is successfully fighting off enemies and will eventually control the situation. The alliance is in total control. Parrots one common meme. This is a delusion. Life is in control, and the reason change is happening now when it never could before is because, 1/life itself is making it happen, and 2/enough of us are now saying yes to it and have been willing to work on our inner material. Think about this. It is the only answer to why we have been unable for so long to effect positive change in our world. Humanity is not yet in an age of peace, happiness, and freedom because it has not yet chosen and fully committed to have unity and to return to its original state of innocence. It has not surrendered its obsession with duality, judgment, blame, and conflict. Dark and light are complementary forces alternating in dominance, like day and night do, but in fact are just two sides of the same one thing playing a game of catch with itself. Humanity is now at the point where it must accept that the strategy of fighting against enemies is self-defeating. Only by dropping this egocentric viewpoint and falling into the natural mind of unity consciousness can we embrace the dark and light inside us, and in holding them together as one, transcend war to have peace. This is so simple it sounds stupid. To have peace, we must stop fighting. To have a higher level world, we have to behave that way, because we are the world. Learning this great lesson allows humanity to live in a state where there is respected individuality in community, independence in cooperation, and prosperity in sharing. This is a state of the Aquarian Age, one of unity consciousness, not fear-driven, desperate, savior-seeking behavior, that accomplishes this transition. We simply cannot fight our way into the next highest dimension. The key to doing this and resolving our global dilemma is to disengage from identifying with the ego in separation with all its fearful, negative imagery, and useless, self-centered, reactive behaviors, and to fall back into trust of our natural state, unity consciousness. This, in fact, is the ultimate premise and teaching of all true systems of spiritual cultivation, from the ancient mystery schools of Egypt and Greece, which spun the original and true cult of Christianity, Gnosticism, to Polynesian and Oriental mysticism which birthed Huna and Taoism, spiritual cultures based on loving relationship with all beings, the earth, and the heavens. These oneness-based religions reflect our origins and our destiny. Their purpose is to make us remember that each one of is a Christ. From an inner state of unity, which implies a deep and total trust of the divine, everything is handled perfectly, effortlessly, without interference, because there is alignment with the divine source, which really is omniscient, omnipresent, and omnipotent. In other words, the ego is no longer directing the action, the inner Christ is. This is the natural way, our natural way. Enough of us right now are going to have to get effing tired enough of the suffering egocentrism has produced that we willingly surrender our gripes and addictions for a higher experience. This is a soul maturing process. We are going through the personal ordeal of self-examination and self-purification, turning our lead into gold. Our old, rigid forms of isolated egos are being cooked down into a cosmic soup made of relaxed and unified ingredients, all of which are still recognizable for what they individually are. Our purified essences alone can enter the next level of human experience. So, again, how this is not a battle. Understand that the dark force is a manifestation of unresolved energies in our group psyche control us as long as we fight with them, with each other, or within our own individual psyches, because they are our forces gone wayward, left unattended. Change your perspective from other-based to unity-based and this becomes clear. When we stop using fighting as a way to cope with life, an act that takes place in the dark of our soul, and turn to higher, brighter, love-based consciousness, we shift our frequency, and that higher rate of vibration, divine light consciousness, disappears the darkness. Our darkness. As we are not yet conscious that all is one, we have to learn now to bring consciousness to our situation in order to change it, The psychological rule says that when an inner situation is not made conscious, it happens outside, is fate. That is to say, when the individual remains divided and does not become conscious of his inner opposite, the world must perforce act out the conflict and be torn into opposing halves. The individual soul psyche is a microcosm of the group soul of humanity, the macrocosm. This is how it will be done. As many are now realizing when they ask why this is taking so long, the strength of the dark forces had been greatly underestimated. It's taken so long because we haven't spent enough time going through the inner ordeal of self-examination, owning up to what's been inside us, and applying love and forgiveness so we can heal unify. Note, forgiving does not mean condoning. It means letting something go so we can move on. This process entails correction, but not punishment. We have been too entertained by looking outside ourselves as a diversion to keep from realizing just how much pain and suffering has been inside. That's why we are finding so much hidden dark behavior in our society now. The outer world comes from the inner world and is its reflection. We have been trying to take the easy way out through blame and distraction. Fortunately, we are now being forced to come clean by the incoming light and love of the universe. It is this divine energy that is making it possible for any earthly forces like white hats to make progress in cleaning up the cabal. This loving light, not any external entity like the Alliance, is the real Calvary, the true Messiah. Author's rebuke, sorry Christian friends, Jesus is not going to save you. That idea is the biggest piece of propaganda ever presented to humanity by its dark forces. One has to go through the personal ordeal of self-examination for oneself. Jesus' primary mission was to show us what it's like to be free so we could opt for that. When he said, "All the things I can do, you can do," he wasn't kidding, because his primary message was, "Be like me." To get all excited and jump up and down doing a devotion dance where you proclaim how wonderful it was that Jesus died for your sins and now you don't have to do a damn thing but accept Jesus as your personal savior and you'll be fine is a total, irresponsible delusion, and it is holding back the evolution of humanity because of that. So get up off your lazy, self-righteous butts and practice what he preached. Truth and reconciliation for those nasty SATA.NI.ST buggers and acceptance of all others whose forms don't meet your self-important standards. Those of us who do love-based spiritual practices that you insist on misrepresenting as devil worship instead of trying to show how forgiven and better you all are. It's Christmas, which is really solstice, so now's a good time to drop this load and help the cause. Amen. The key factor. Understanding all this reveals the key factor that clarifies why we haven't reached our breakthrough point yet. That factor has been disunity. The lack of dynamic, cooperative group focus on a stated intent is powerful divine beings from a unified level of consciousness among those of us who want a new earth. I previously have believed that our delays were being caused mostly by the normies, the laggard population that refuses to look at anything, especially the truth. Recently, I have come to understand that it is more our responsibility because, while they have tremendous inertia, we are the ones with the power to change things because we who are more conscious of what's really going on are the ones who can willingly use our divinely bestowed creative ability. If we just get organized and do it. Intention put forth with the proper feeling tone creates reality. Though we may be a small percentage of the world population, our combined, resonant energies can shift the frequency here, because when we unify stopping all negative, divisive or self-indulgent behavior, the radiant field we create will be more powerful than the one that has existed up to now. And just as a large tuning fork will change the frequency note emanating from a smaller one next to it, our unified, superior tone, in alignment with divine powers, will wash over the planet and change its entire field. We actually have been doing this in increments, slowly over time, and we are close to a shift of great proportion. As we watch the old false narratives crumbling rapidly now, we need to boost our efforts to transcend our ego's differing agendas and focus on what we have in common. We want a free world aligned with spirit. We want to live happily ever after. I have written articles in the past about the importance of the solstices and equinoxes as huge natural doorways where spirit comes through to recreate life on Earth. Solstices and equinoxes are three-day windows of pure primordial energy, the most spiritually powerful days of the year. Creation, which is the body of spirit, is innately aligned with itself from top to bottom, and the love and light released from the purest levels of spirit make their way down through the dimensions to us in especially powerful ways at these temporal markers. These times are more than just astrological transits. They are cosmic doorways to the infinite. Winter solstice is the segue between the ending of one solar year and the beginning of a new one. The last molecules of one year's energy breath are spent, and there is a pause of deepest profundity before the universe sends out a new breath of life, a new solar year. It is the emptiest of times, and emptiness is what we need now to make our shift. Willfully surrendering our old world and old personal selves with their painful memories into the spiritual void of the solstice allows us to recreate ourselves and our world by then and putting our vision and excitement for a better world. The surrender of our past is our yes to our new future. During this three-day transition period, the day before, the day of, and the day after, in between one year and the next, the universe vacuums out old energies and polishes everything in creation. It cleans house for us. Because of all the momentum we've built thus far, banding together under our shared intention at this particular time, especially at the exact hour of the solstice, will be extraordinarily powerful. Our intention is to have a unified, free world. This is what we are creating to replace the suffering-filled one we created when we got confused a long, long time ago and forgot what we really are. Stop obsessing on what all the little players on the stage are doing and go within. Don't listen when anyone tells you to stock up, there might be shortages. Instead, picture how you prefer it to be and put your faith in that image. See a fullness of life experience instead of the passé images of lack we were taught to believe in. Gather yourself in the quiet space and meditate and imagine, pray with confident intent as a great being aligned with the infinite source who owns his or her innate power. Do this as much as possible starting now, especially at the solstice, and continuing daily thereafter, and see the magic of life spring us forth into a new world of unity, peace, prosperity, freedom, and love. Imagine it real now. Forgive and forget everything else. Hello galactic family. Hello to all who like Gaia Planetary Station, I would like to thank you for being together to learn and grow the light. Improving every step and knowing that the energies of light are making an incredible cleaning of the universe and planet Earth is the great jewelry of this monumental change. All who are connected with their higher self must follow their own missions. Here I present some of the products of the store, search to see if you like something. For those who want to make donations to the channel by PayPal, we have the donation link to the channel. Subscribe to the channel, be a channel member, always comment on the videos and click on like button. Thank you for the amazing messages, the fun conversations and participations in the chat of the videos. I am happy that many warriors of light are together in this new age. May 2021 be incredible for everyone.